Hello everyone, it's George and welcome back to Call of Dragons. As dedicated free-to-play player who played this game for more than 400 days, I'm excited to share some insider tips and tricks with you. Stick around and let's dive in. Today we are going to speak about the special units of the Spring Wardens, simply because we spoke about Wyverns, we spoke about Celestials, and of course it's time for us to speak about Eagles and everything what you need to do in order for you to play well with the Forest Eagles, right? Forest Eagles are special units of the Spring Wardens faction. It's a cavalry melee flying units. We need to mention that it's melee, it's not range. And well, Spring Wardens of course has cavalry units, which is elk riders, which are like archers on the horses on the elks, which means it's not a melee range. And besides that, only Forest Eagles are cavalry melee whenever you are playing at the Spring Wardens, right? There is a big difference between those two. For example, Elk Riders has a physical attack bonus whenever you are playing with Elk Riders from the range, and for the Forest Eagles, when they encounter isolated enemies, they swoop from the Great Heights to inflict their wrath upon unsuspected foes. What does this mean, right? It means that Forest Eagle is dealing more damage whenever you are dealing legions which are alone, isolated, which means it's a great units for flanking, for killing the legions whenever they are trying to refill on the battlefield. So it's like a flanking gameplay, and generally that's the gameplay for cavalry players who likes to play with cavs, because that's the only use so far for the cavs in this game, right? Let's dig inside and let's think what kind of hero pairs, artifacts, war pets, and talents will be great for the Forest Eagles. So let's start with the hero pairs, because I think that's the most important whenever we are speaking about some different kind of legions such as Eagles, right? The one and the main hero pair for the Forest Eagles, which will be working pretty fine, is that it will be Forondil with Thea, right? Forondil, it's pretty easy to understand. Even the look of the Forondil looks like it's an eagle. And of course, the skill sets and the synergies which Forondil and Thea has in terms of Forest Eagles gameplay is simply amazing. First of all, the Shattering Screech. It's a main skill of the Forondil, dealing 1200 skill damage factor. And what's important in this skill is that it applies cowardice. Cowardice simply means that any normal attack which enemy will deal you will be miss, right? Which won't gonna hit you. Of course, on a 5 level, the miss will be 3 seconds, and actually 3 seconds are quite a lot. It's like being immune from the normal attacks for 3 seconds, which is quite impressive, right? The second skill is defense penetration until to 10%, and in general I really like defense breaks, defense penetrations, and magic defense penetrations in any heroes in this game. The third skill, which is really interesting skill, it has a two ways, right? If you are playing for only the primary hero, you will get march speed 10%, march speed bonus up to 20%, and damage dealt up to 10%. If you are playing Forondil as a deputy, you are getting skill damage bonus 10% and rage cost reduction up to 50%. In my opinion, from this, as I have mentioned, Forondil is more of a primary hero whenever you are playing with Thea, so we look at the march speed bonus and the damage dealt bonus, which I like more rather than being deputy. The fourth skill is really good. Legion gains 40% attack bonus. 40% is a lot, right? And like bonus reduced by minus 5% every 20 seconds, which means whenever you're gonna enter to the battlefield, the first couple of seconds, you will have 40% more attack bonus, which is huge. In terms of awakening skill, it's pretty good in terms of Forondil. When Forondil's legion launches a normal attack against the legion that has cowardice, and applying cowardice is really easy on Forondil, they have a 50% of inflicting physical defense break and slow for 3 seconds. This can be triggered every 5 seconds. Every 5 seconds is a quite low amount, and defense break and march speed reduction is quite good, simply because you will be way faster in general whenever you are playing with the Eagles and Forondil. So what kind of synergies Forondil has with Thea? In my opinion, every single hero has synergy with Thea. Thea will make 4-on deal way tankier, which will mean that you're gonna deal more damage as long as you're gonna stay alive longer. Hero skill damage dealt 15% because 4-on deal is dealing 1200 skill damage factor, and you're gonna add 15% to that. Again, attack bonuses, being more tanky, skill damage taken reduction, defense attack bonus, march speed bonus, every single skill which you are having here, and like attribute bonus is amazing for 4-on deal, right? Fourth skill is again attack bonus, max attack bonus, great, great stat bonuses for the 4-on deal in order for you to be as fast as possible, and also in order for you to be as damage dealer as possible, because your main idea is to just go inside the battlefield, deal as much damage as possible, and then go back. That's the main idea about cavalry hero pairs. That's how they work, and in Eagle's cases you will be much, much faster than any other cavalry hero pair, because in general I think Eagle's 4-on deal and Thea is the fastest march speed which we can have in Call of Dragons so far. And also they gave us a better theme, a better like graphic visuals for Eagles whenever you are playing with them, so it will be like more fun for you to just try how good this hero pair will be. Well, Thea is amazing for every single flying unit, and I think 4-on deal and Thea is the best hero pair for the Forest Eagles which you can play so far, right? In terms of talents for this hero pair, well, it's really easy to understand. I generally don't like control trees. I like here I would be going for cavalry tree with some PvP tree, PvP points, because PvP points is giving you a lot of damage and defensive stats, right? So whenever you're gonna try to build up talents for 4-on deal, try to read it at first. That's why I always advise just not copy and paste the talent trees for other people. Try to read what you are actually choosing, and you will like manage your gameplay around your talents. Main talents are here perfect ferocity and steady face. Well, steady face is like shield factor 600, but I think Thea will give you enough shield factor, so I will be going for perfect ferocity. And the main talents are blood mark and inescapable, right? Inescapable is like giving inflict defense break, march speed, defense break 5% for 3 seconds, and all of these stats can be applied every 30 seconds. And blood mark is generally like rage casting skill, which gonna give us 150 more damage physical factor. So I think inescapable and perfect ferocity should be the one talent choice which you guys should try it out whenever you are playing as 4-on deal. And secondary trial talent tree, I would go for PvP, Army of Valor, or Luck of the Draw, depending on your gameplay. As always, I will mention it again, just don't copy and paste talent trees of other players. Just try to build it your own, read it what they are giving you, because developers of the game made these talents way, way more accessible and more good in terms of readable what they are actually giving you. In terms of artifacts for 4-on deal and Thea, there is also like couple of choices, right? Some people might tell you that also of the Storm Peak should be the number one choice, but I don't generally agree about that. Clone can be nice, of course. Additional effect can be cool. Damage dealt plus 4% is nice, but there is way more better artifacts in order for you to deal more and more damage. And of course, Spring Blades are amazing in this category. Spring Blades are damage dealer artifact. You also gonna get additional effect attack 15% for 5 seconds, which is quite good. And in general, Spring Blades are amazing merit farmer artifact. And mainly whenever you are playing with Eagles, you would like to go inside the fight, deal as much damage as possible, and run away, right? That's the main gameplay about Eagles. So Spring Blades ticks all the boxes whenever we are talking about this type of gameplay, right? Now, the other artifacts, of course, you can always run also the Storm Peak, but I would not go as a number one priority, but it's a pretty good artifact in general, right? For the free-to-play friendly artifacts, Well, there is a couple of choices. Kingslayer is quite good. Actually, Kingslayer is the best free-to-play artifact which you can get from the normal keys from the Universal Compendium. And the last choice, I would say, is a Sorland's Blade. That's the weaker version of Kingslayer, which is dealing damage to 2 enemy legions, and Kingslayer is dealing damage to 5 enemy legions. So I think the best choices are Spring Blades, Oath of the Storm Peak, and that's it in terms of best choices. Secondary choices, of course, for free-to-play friendly players. Kingslayer, best one for free-to-play players, and Sorland's Blade is secondary choice. That's all about artifacts. I think that's like pretty limited in terms of artifacts for cavalry players. We have way more for infantry and mages, of course, right? In terms of war pets, we have one war pet which is exactly great for four-only hero pairs, which is Berserker Phagedrake, right? Berserker Phagedrake is a perfect war pet for the four-only hero pair simply because of the arrogance skill, and it's pretty easy to understand why, right? Let's read it and you guys will understand really, really easily why this warpet is perfect for Forondil. Each debuff inflicted on a target legion grants one stack of first mark. Inflicting Cowardice grants an extra 2 stacks, right? Cowardice was all about Forondil's main skill. You are applying Cowardice whenever you are playing with Forondil, like almost 100%. So you will be happy having these fierce marks way more easier with Forondil than any other legion. All stacks of the fierce mark are consumed in 2 seconds after your deputy casts a rage skill, dealing damage to target, right? This is like perfect warped skill for Forondil gameplay. I think synergy is really, really high in terms of arrogance and in terms of general gameplay of Forondil and Thea. And of course, how would you finish the warped? As always, I like first attack synergies on my cavalry hero pairs because like more rage skill you are using, more damage you are dealing, and that's the way of building the almost every single cavalry warpet in my opinion. And this is not exclusion. I like this warpet a lot, especially for Forondil. And the main stats would be like agility, the primary stat, strength, and luck. That should be the main stats, and you should be trying to get a legendary warpet, and getting like S tier on agility, strength, and luck would make this warped way, way better than anything else. Of course, the secondary warped which you can use if you don't have Berserker Phagedrake would be Golden Rock. Golden Rock, of course, is more preferable for a gameplay of Emrys and Bakshi because they are more specialized with the rage accumulation speed, but nobody said that it would be bad on Forondil. But still, I would say second tier is Golden Rock for Forondil, and S tier and number one tier should be Berserker Phagedrake whenever you are playing as a Forondil primary hero, right? That's the main idea behind Forondil and Thea gameplay. In terms of how you can actually get Forondil is through the lucky spins. There is a choice lucky spin almost every 2 or 3 weeks in this game. You can choose Forondil from there. You can simply easily unlock Forondil from the lucky spins. You just need to have a 10 Forondil skills in order for you to unlock this legendary hero. And in terms of Thea, you can actually get Thea from the gold chest. Let's say most free-to-play friendly legendary heroes are here, when you can just get them from the normal gameplay, not spending any funds in this game. And of course, if you already have Forondil, choose the Forondil on a VIP shop, so you will be able to get Forondil tokens one per day, and you will be getting Thea's legendary tokens just by playing the game. That's how you can actually level up the skills of these two heroes, so you will be strong enough. Of course, you kind of have to be playing with the Spring Wardens faction whenever you are playing as a Forondil and Eagles. That's the only way. So if you are Spring Wardens, if you like Forest Eagles, Forondil and Thea will be amazing for you, you know, in terms of damage, in terms of merits, and in terms of every single aspect of the game, whenever you are playing at the Spring Wardens. This is all I wanted to speak about Forest Eagles. It's a really, really interesting and fun gameplay. You should be the number one in terms of march speed around the battlefield, but my main advice would be to just try to flank enemies, try to defeat the refilling legions who are just going to the main battlefront. That's like main gameplay, how you can actually have fun while playing with the Poroldil and Thea. And as always, guys, if you like the video, press like, subscribe, share. It always gives me more and more motivation to make more content for this amazing game. I hope everybody will have amazing day, morning or night, wherever you are. We are going to see each other really, really soon. Bye-bye and good luck.